A fresh choice for Davaoenos, that's how former Cabinet Secretary Carlo Nograles described himself as he seeks to challenge his former boss, Rodrigo Duterte. Nograles filed his certificate of candidacy Tuesday for Davao City Mayor. Nograles says he will bring a new kind of leadership to the city. He also vows to address Davao's flooding problems.
Itong pagpasok ko dito is a big step forward already for Davao. It's a big leap. Sabi ko nga, pagpasok ko dito, at least my choice na. So it now becomes 50-50, right? It's a 50-50 choice. Choice A, choice B, it's 50-50 now. And it's really up to the Davaoenos to make that choice. At we have 6 months to go. Give me time to explain to you what we want to do.
Anong mensahe mo kay dating Pangulong Duterte?
Mr. President, boss, andito na po tayo. Let's give Davao a choice. This is about giving Davao a choice. This is for the people of Davao.
A three-term congressman of Davao City's 1st District, Nograles was appointed cabinet secretary under the Duterte administration from 2018 to 2022. He was appointed chairman of the Civil Service Commission shortly after, until his resignation last Monday. Resigned Interior Secretary and senatorial aspirant Benner Abalos formally hands over the reins of the DILG to his successor, John Vic Remulla. Michael Deliso on the line with that story. Michael, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. Outgoing Interior Secretary Benner Abalos has formally turned over his post to John Vic Remulla as the former 6th Senate seat in the 2025 election. Abalos, a longtime politician, admitted heading the Department of Interior and Local Government, or DILG, had been his most challenging post yet, but said he believed his term was a success. Abalos expressed confidence he was leaving the department in the hands of, quote, a very, very capable and qualified person.
Napakalawak po ng kapangyarihan ng DILG. Ako po'y naging alkalde ng Mandaluyong, naging congressman, naging MMDA chairman, ito na siguro pinakamahirap na posisyon na hinawakan ko, ang maging sekretaryo ng DILG. Ngunit, mahirap man, nalampasan namin ang lahat ng hamon. No? And I'm proud to say that it has been a successful term.
Remulla, for his part, admitted that DILG would be difficult to manage. Remulla served in the local government of Cavite for nearly three decades. He has stepped down as governor, with his vice governor, Asina Tolentino, replacing him as head of the Philippines' second most vote-rich province. The former Cavite governor is the second Remulla in President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s cabinet, as Boying Remulla, an elder sibling, is serving as the head of the Department of Justice. Meantime, Remulla said he had already called and warned the Philippine offshore gaming operator, or Pogo Hub, in Island Grove, his family's former resort property in Cavite. He said the Cavite Pogo voluntarily set December 15 shutdown. Marcos earlier set a December 31 deadline to ban all Pogos in the country after the industry was linked to criminal activities and security concerns. Remulla said he will personally oversee the shutdown of each Pogo Hub in the country, 80% of which operate in Metro Manila.
After that, I will go to each and every one. December 31 is the directive of the president. So between December 15 and 31, we're going to make sure that everything is closed.
Remulla had repeatedly denied allegation that he and his family had been protectors of Pogos, even offering a 10 million peso reward to anyone who could prove their ties in the operations of the Pogo Hub in Island Cove. He explained that the property was sold by their family in 2018. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Michael Deliso, there joining us on the line. The official residence of the Philippine President in Manila has received a much-needed facelift. Architect Conrad Onglao says the Bahay Pangulo had to be renovated due to severe structural damage caused by termites and a strong earthquake in 2022. Lush greenery and tropical plants were also added to the compound, giving it a resort-like vibe. Onglao says the architectural style he used was Filipino modern, based on the preference of First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos.
Ang gusto lang ni First Lady na sabi niya, Conrad, I want you to make it feel like a resort. Kasi yun din yung idea from the beginning, so the presidents can relax. Sabi niya, siyempre, pagdating ni presidente, pagod siya, parang gusto lang niya na-relax. So that was the premise.
Ong Lau says he doesn't know how much was spent on the renovation, but he assures the public the property will now last for several administrations more.